All right, everyone, welcome to our next video in the collections tournament. So the polls are closed between Wednesday, are now closed for Wednesday's matchup. We've put the yo-yo quilt against the Robert Young Rail Yard. The vote was a lot closer than we thought it was going to be, but the winner moving on in the tournament is the Robert Young Rail Yard photo. So in the Elite Eight, we'll see the Palm Sunday Tornado photo versus the Robert Young Rail Yard photo. So that'll be a really exciting matchup. I'll be interested to see what you vote for that one. But today, we have a really, another really tight matchup, which has Emma Molloy's Elkhart Observer newspaper versus Ted Drake's Leprechaun sketch. So just like we've done in the past, when we post this video, there'll be a poll. You'll be able to vote. This vote's gonna go a little bit longer than normal because this is Friday, so it'll be the weekend, so you'll have an extra day to vote. And on Monday, when we post the next video, we'll announce the winners. So let's get into today's matchup. First, we have the Elkhart Observer. So it was a newspaper published in Elkhart in 1872. This is the first edition, and you can see August 21st, 1872. The important thing and the interesting thing about this is the publishers of the newspaper. And you can see we have right there, Edward and Emma Molloy. So Emma Molloy was considered or is the first female newspaper editor in Northern Indiana when the Observer comes out in 1872. And this newspaper really launches Emma Molloy's life and career, what follows after. One of the things that Molloy was a proponent of is women's rights, and one of the things we point to is evidence of that, and it's seen throughout the entire run of the newspaper, but on the very first issue, on the very first page, she dedicates a large article and a lot of space to an address made by Susan B. Anthony, and you can see down there at the bottom there. So we're pointing to that and using that as evidence of what Emma Molloy believed in. So she believed in women's suffrage, women's right to have more job opportunities, and the temperance movement. And if you read through the articles of the entire run of the newspaper, you can see her editorials and the things that she's reporting on about what's not just happening here in Elkhart, but the nation. She pushes forward all those causes. And this newspaper really launches her into a career for public advocacy. So she reports about it. When people see the newspaper articles, she gets requests to speak at rallies for temperance movement and women's rights. Then she becomes to be known statewide as a representative. And eventually, she stops editing the newspaper and goes on to a career in public speaking across the nation and even goes into Europe during the 1870s and 1880s, speaking for all these different causes she was a proponent of. So this newspaper really launches her career. So it's very important for Emma Molloy as a really big figure in Elkhart County history. So that's the newspaper and its opponent. And I got to admit, this is a pretty big one, at least for me, because I'm a Notre Dame fan. And if you are too, you're going to recognize this drawing right away. So this is a drawing of the Notre Dame Leprechaun done by Ted Drake. So Ted Drake was born in Goshen, but he lived his life in Elkhart. He was a commercial artist, which he actually got started during World War II as part of the Navy. He worked in the public relations office and created newspaper illustrations. After the war, he worked for Wilson Sporting Goods, creating art for their advertisements as well. In the 1960s, the University of Notre Dame was looking for a new mascot, and they looked to Drake to design it. So they commissioned him, they paid him $50 to design this iconic mascot that we see still today. Now, what you're looking at is a sketch of the mascot, but we want to be sure to say this is not the original drawing that Ted Drake made and gave to the school when they were thinking about designing a new mascot. So what we believe looking at the drawing is this might have been done to symbolize or show the leprechaun on a statue or a trophy or something like that. So no, this is not the original. I'm assuming the university has the original sketches and drawings. But the interesting thing is, and you think about the mascot and how it really, looking at that drawing, it's pretty unaltered from what we see today. So the mascot really hasn't changed all that much from Drake's original ideas. And he was paid $50 whole. So you think how many millions of dollars that mascot has probably made for the university. And Ted Drake only got $50 for it. But when you're a commercial artist, that's how it goes, I guess. So, but it's a pretty good matchup for today. We're going to be really excited to see what people vote for. And it's a pretty good matchup. We have a lot of good matchups coming up here in this next couple few videos. So, as I said, we have the Observer newspaper versus Ted Drake's drawings. We're going to post this later today. Today's Friday. We'll have a poll associated with it, and go ahead and vote, and you'll see which one moves on to the Elite Eight. So I hope everyone's staying safe. Keep washing your hands. Keep social distancing. And we'll see you for our next video on Monday, where we'll see another great matchup and announce the winner of this one. So take care, everyone.